there was one doctor in that team. My kids dubbed him Dr. Death, because he grabbed me one day and put, you know, in a room and said, you know, I want you to sign these papers. That basically was the new do not resuscitate. And I kind of looked at him and I went like, no, I can't do that. Not without my, you know, consulting my family. So that was the one time. I never told my husband that. But anyhow, after everything had happened, he'd been there quite some time, and he was not getting better. So basically, the doctor said, there's not anything more we can do for him here. They were sending us to palliative care, and I knew that at that point, the doctor had said, there's really no hope. You know, he's just, you know, going to deteriorate. So when my husband asked me, why are we going there? And he was in very bad shape. Like, he didn't look like he was going to make it through a week. So when he asked me, why are they moving me? I said, they're moving you because they do not have the facilities here for your, you know, for the physiotherapy that you need in order to get your strength back. And he believed me, because he was doing the physiotherapy. And when I think, mind over matter is such an incredibly strong thing. And my husband's will to live was unbelievable. But I didn't have the heart to tell him, we're taking you there because you're going to die. I just couldn't. So I told him that we were taking him there because he was had a better chance there. And he believed me, and he came home. He got well enough to come home.